So, at the moment, I currently have the engine torn down, and I'm draining out all of the oil so that I can replace the oil pump O-ring, which sits behind it, approximately back there. If you can see, the bottom of the oil pan started showing some signs of an oil leak, and initially I thought, well, perhaps it's just the main seal on the front, the crank seal there. But a Lexus Tech friend of mine pointed out that the only way that you get this kind of leak, and you can see a lot of the oil around here, that is not coming out of the seal for the crank. So the only other places it could be were coming from the bolt there for the number one or two idler pulley, I don't remember which one, the tensioner pulley, or it's coming off the top, which is what I think is more likely, because right about here there's a bunch of oil buildup, and there's no way that that would show up being slung around by the crank or coming from the tensioner pulley. So thank you, Ryan, for pointing this out to me. But basically the process here is removing the timing belt, which I've already done. I took off the crank pulley, and the next step in the process is to actually go ahead and remove the oil pump, which is a pain and a half, so much so that the factory service manual actually recommends removing the engine to do this, but I don't have an engine stand, so I decided to do it the hard way, which meant actually removing my front differential. So there's no front diff here. It's currently on my shelf with a brand new locker that I installed in it. So that's gonna go on in a second. But first I have to do some maintenance. So gotta remove the front diff in order to do this in the truck, unless you want to remove the engine, which, you know, nobody wants to do that. So first step is to remove the dipstick. So I'm gonna get to it. Driver's side fender here, and there's a 12 millimeter bolt that I'm attempting to get. All right, I wound up just using a box end wrench, and I was able to get in there. And it's just that one. Let's see here. There she goes. Just a 12 millimeter. I found the easiest tool to use is a paint scraper. You can just get it in there and wiggle it around and pry the FIPG apart. I also used razor blades, just like this, and a small hammer to knock those in and create a little bit of separation between the two pieces. So that works pretty well, but it's coming off. Should be ready in just a minute. All right, here she comes.
Number two oil pan is down.
Once you remove the number two oil pan, the bottom one, there are four bolts and two nuts per the service manual. Nut, the rest are bolts, just to remove that little plate, and then it'll be time to pull the oil slinger. Well, there it goes, some oil. Alright, so in the factory service manual, it says to remove the 18 bolts and nuts holding on the number one oil pan, but the problem with that is that there are also these bolts, which I think there are four of them total, that are holding the number one oil pan to the transmission. So I need to remove that, as well as this little plate that guards the flywheel. So I'm gonna do that, then I can pull the number one oil pan, then I can remove the oil slinger. And once all of that is taken care of, I can get the oil pump out. So, we're making progress. Alright, so I've removed those bolts, the bolts on this side. I'm keeping one bolt on each side in the back, slightly threaded just in case this thing drops, because I don't want it to do that. Then there are four 10 millimeter bolts here on the front, and they're easiest to reach with a ratcheting 10 millimeter. So that's what I've been doing with those. Here's a nice shot of that scraper, which is currently inside there. So that's how that's going. We're getting closer. Alright, so I got the number one oil pan out. Now there are some 10 millimeter bolts holding the oil strainer on, and two 10 millimeter nuts holding it in place over there. And there's a gasket that's gonna fall out. So here we go. Okay. Alright. Not sure how well you can tell, but part of the gasket has left itself where the oil strainer went, so I'm gonna have to scrape that off with a razor blade. But shouldn't be too bad. Just a little paper gasket. Here's all your hardware. Oil pan. Front diff. Pulleys. All that nonsense. Here's the number one, or the upper oil pan. Working on cleaning the surface here. Alright, so on here there are 8 bolts total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This one here is a 14 millimeter, and this is a 6 millimeter Allen head. So I'll probably do that off screen, but there you go. That's what we're doing. Alright, this guy is why we're here. And it looks like that's the culprit. Alright, so, oil pump. Gonna put in a new seal because we're in there, might as well. It'll be real easy. As far as part numbers are concerned, I've got the oil strainer gasket, O-ring for the dipstick, O-ring for the engine block, the gasket for the oil filter, the O-ring for the oil filter, but I didn't actually disassemble that, so I might not need that. And then just a couple of water hoses, one that comes out of the side of the block and goes into the oil cooler. So that's all that. I'm gonna replace that seal and clean this up and put it back in. I went ahead and torqued this thing back up. The 12 millimeter bolts, the 12 mils and the 6 mil Allen are torqued up to 11 foot-pounds, and the 14 millimeter is torqued up to 22 foot-pounds. I also put in the seal, and I recommend putting it in after you install the pump. I found out the hard way that it's a good way to break one, so don't do that. Put the seal in after you put the pump in. I had an extra, so I got lucky. Gasket. And time to put that guy on. Right now.
is good at 66 inch pounds. Back in place. These get torqued to 27 foot-pounds. These get torqued to 21 foot-pounds. And that small 10 millimeters get torqued to 66 inch-pounds. There are four up here on the front, two in the back. The rest are all 12s. And those get to 21. And these here are, whatchamacallit, 27 foot-pounds, and don't forget to put the flywheel cover back in, and I'm going to torque that to 11 foot-pounds, maybe more like 15. Alright, so I've cleaned the mating surface, and I put the baffle oil plate on. There are four 10 millimeter bolts on my truck, and two 10 millimeter nuts that get torqued up to 66 foot pounds. But on other models, apparently they're 12 millimeters. So keep that in mind. But I think the torque specs are the same. All right, just finish this up. These are all 10 mils. They are 20 bolts and two nuts. All get torqued up to 66 inch pounds. So those are good to go, and both oil pans have now been installed. Just gotta put the oil cooler back on, and then I can start reassembling this truck. All right, well, I've got this side repaired now, reassembled. I reinstalled the dipstick there for the oil, the engine oil, and there's an O-ring that goes into the top of the number number one oil pan, so that's right up here. And then I also, looks like we lost our light. I also put the oil filter housing back in, which is pretty tricky, and to be honest, I'm not sure that I have done it with a perfect flush seal, but there are two 12 millimeter bolts, one you can see right there, and there's a 12 millimeter nut on the top in sort of a triangle shape. So that's that. It's pretty difficult to get to those, so I used a 12 millimeter ratcheting flex heads wrench, and that helped a lot, but it's a lot of wiggling stuff around. And then I put in a new coolant hose there.
Stirring the fire. lost the ways and know to mask the pain. No.